It started. The countdown has begun.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Gather your friends. Gather your family. We've got more StarCraft action coming to you right now. Torre, sing us into this one.
Oh, see, can you see? Here at Imba TV today with Andre.
Fan-freaking-tastic. And we got Beastyqt spawning in the 3 o'clock position on Metalopolis as the Yellow Terran. And over here, we've got the Teal Terran, piloted by Stareagle. Now, currently, these players are both sitting on 1-1. And what do you think, Andre?
Yeah, I'm just thinking it's not only... you said friend-freaking-tastic. I have to agree with you abso-fucking-lutely. And yeah, I'm happy about this. I'm happy about this best of five just becoming a best of three, so we have at least two more games to cast. And I mean, Beastie just did an awesome job in game number one, no question about this. He absolutely destroyed Stareagle and took him apart. But the super small timing push by Stareagle in the second game, I mean, he was not expecting to kill Beastie. He was surprised as we were, but it was enough to take out Beastie because of his super awesome timing. And now I'm just saying everything can happen here in game number three.
You know, I agree with that, man. I think it's going to turn into quite the macro game from both these players because of the mass, or like the large distance between them as they are cross positions. And I believe this one only has cross positions, or this one has all cross, or only cross positions. Am I right or am I wrong?
Hey, you're half right. It is
non- half right.
It is non-close positions. You can join cross positions.
That's right.
And you can spawn close positions by air, but no close positions by ground.
All right.
So we see Stareagle actually once again going for this. Wait. Do I see a barrack somewhere? Actually,
nope.
I don't. So command center first play at the natural expansion is coming up. I mean, you can't be just more bold than that. And Beastie is of course going for the barracks, getting out some marines to defend a possible Reaper attack. But now with this SCV, he will spot what's going on. He is about to move up the ramp, and there he sees the command center right away. So he knows what's up. He knows Stareagle is going all macro on him.
Yeah, you know, Stareagle is a building for this macro-type game. Beastyqt noticing this. What will the reaction be? It looks like a factory is going down by Beastyqt. Could he be going for the 1-1-1 build and getting that Cloak Banshee out so he can try to harass?
I mean, this is super harassment build. This 100% Harrison Ford build he was doing in the first game could be eligible once again, because if Stareagle is going for this command center first, he will have a lot of SCV out pretty soon, and a lot of SCVs are always a good thing to target if you're going all harassment on him. But we do not see an add-on here on the barracks. We see the factory is finished right now, and he does have enough gas to go for the starport right away. But let's just see, do we see the starport, and do we see a tech lab on this factory after the Hellion is finished? This is the big question.
And it looks like a factory is... There's the starport right there. Beastyqt going right into the front of Stareagle's base with three Marines and one SCV. He is taking out this bunker. He is laying down another bunker. He's trying to deny the macro base build that's going on for Stareagle by using these Marines aggressively and the SCV as well. And he will have to cancel that bunker and get those Marines out of town as this urban warfare continues.
Urban warfare, very nice call. So this bunker will be finished in the next 3 seconds, and he just needs this bunker to finish, get this last marine in there. But no, the marine is not getting in there. Stareagle knows he's in a lot of trouble, and now Beastie is in the base here of Stareagle, and with this Hellion having this super cone attack, he is able to do a lot of damage. Now the marines are not getting down the ramp, and now the SCV is actually surrounding the SCV, the Hellion, but the marines of Beastie just taking out more SCVs, and Stareagle is in a loft of trouble. Lost 11 SCVs already. GG is called.
And there it is, the GG. Wow, that was not a long macro game as we were all planning for it to be. And it looks like Beastie will go ahead and take the lead in the points. bringing him to 2 points and Star Eagle only on one. And wowie, wowie, you don't want a macro build against Beastie, don't, isn't that right?
I mean, in this second game, Beastie just missed 3 seconds to get his tanks sieged up. Now, in this game, Stareagle only missed 1 single second to get these Marines in the bunker. I mean, cannot get more close than that.
Agreed.
Even though those last two games were pretty short, they were freaking close. Because if he would be in that bunker, and if this base of this attack could have been defended, Stareagle would be in such an awesome position in terms of economy. But he did not, so yeah. Beastie's up to one.
That's right, and it's up to Stareagle to choose the map for the next game here. And I do want to go ahead and say a little bit, you know, let's go ahead and pour at each other a little bit here, Endry. You guys can follow Imba TV at imbalance.tv as well as facebook.com/ImbaTV. For every time we go live, we will post on Facebook that we are live, and sometimes we may not be doing big events or things like that, and we may be going live for some shows that we're starting, and it's best to follow us there to, you know, get an idea of what's going on. We've also got the Gopher SE2 Cup being covered by Imba TV tomorrow. And I'm ready for that.
So what are you? Everybody knows, I got my webpage, android.com, where you find all VODs, all information, all the Twitters, the YouTube channel, the information, and all that good jazz. And, of course, most importantly, is actually my Facebook page, because if I'm not in the chat, I am interacting with my community via the Facebook. If I have something to say, if I made some funny pictures like I did today regarding my threat on Team Liquid for all this tournament.
The Forever Alone picture, I do remember that earlier today.
Yeah. I was so proud of my tournament threat, and then, like, nobody posted there, and I have to post, like, 3 times in a row to just get some news out there, and then it is forever alone indeed. So the new map is up. It is Stareagle. And no, he wanted to play on dual side. Now he's telling me dual side it is, so let me open it once again. So he was just taking test buck to be dual side.
And what'd you say, Tore?
Hard verdamme.
What do you mean, what?
Deutsch, goddamn.
Oh, okay. Yeah, see, I didn't know. Anyways, dual site will be the next map. This was chosen by Stareagle and Beastyqt against Stareagle here.
And looks like Beastie said this map was vetoed out, so that's why dual site is the map right now. So let me just get in contact with the players to confirm that.
And let me go ahead and get on some music here.
Oh, actually, once again, I was muted. I just wanted to say that Beastie does not like Test Bug at all, and that's why he vetoed this map.
Gotcha.